Hello, dissenters, and welcome back from our short holiday break. Hope you've been hungry for some more Slime Rancher. I admit I've been dreaming of this game a bit myself over Christmas. Speaking of hungry, though, we have some responsibilities to attend to, like making sure our stock of carrots is full for our pink slimes, currently bashing their heads against the walls. They look especially hungry right now. I don't want to use all the carrots, however, because we still have a few rock slimes in here that require some feeding. I'd like to add more than just four simple rock slimes. There's not enough of these little guys out here, and we require some meat for the tabby slimes. While we're on the subject of food, I've discovered something in previous videos that I forgot to mention, and that is that we need to be replanting our sources of food. What do I mean by that? Well, you can see that the poke fruit tree is empty. That's because even though there was a tree there, we need to plant another pogo fruit to make sure another yield becomes available to us in the near future. Similarly, I recently harvested my carrots and I want to make sure we have at least one carrot to plant some more into the soil. You'll probably notice after selling so many of our plorts, and that reminds me, I've got 23 pink plorts over here to absorb. We've got over 950 coins. Okay, we may have overdone it a little bit here. Hopefully those plorts just sitting out and about don't cause any problems with the nearby slimes. But with all of this money, I gotta figure out what I want to buy. There's so many choices, aren't there? I think first and foremost, I would like to make some more of these tabby largos because they're so versatile, aren't they? But to keep them all inside the walls, we're going to need to increase the strength of our walls. Make sure they cannot just jump out whenever they want. They are currently the most likely to escape, so we gotta be extra careful. One issue in particular has come to my attention, and that is the fact that we need a place to store all this extra stuff. I got 20 poke fruits, nothing to do with them, because I mistakenly put carrots in the feeder for the pink slimes when I should have put poke fruit in. No, you can't vacuum the carrots back out, so we just have to wait until they eat them all. The carrots, of course, would be much better in an auto feeder for my rock slimes over here, but I would like to just make a new building instead. I think that is reasonable, and we've got this empty plot over here that is centralized in the ranch. I don't want to put my storage unit, my silo, in the new area that we recently unlocked, so we're just going to build it right here and see what this is. I have no idea how it's going to operate, and what I hope is that it holds more than one type of item. It does not. Come to find out, this storage unit does absolutely nothing for my problem, but at the bare minimum, I can put all my poke fruits in here for safekeeping. I've also noticed that we're not producing as many chickens as I would like. We do need a good source of meat, especially for the tabby slimes. It's the one that is just not sustainable compared to the pogo fruits and the carrots. So let's see what we can upgrade in our coop. We can do high walls to keep chickens in and hungry slimes out. We can do spring grass that produces eggs twice as fast, or the Vitamizer allows chickens to grow into healthy hens and roosters twice as fast. The spring grass makes the most sense for me, just to get double the eggs. So with that purchase, you can see it is a little bit more wormy inside the coop now. They've got an extra source of food here with this tall grass. They can hunt and peck. Look at them, they're eating right now. And hopefully we're gonna have a better supply of chickens. Now, I do have a nighttime goal that I would like to accomplish. The reason why we are here at close to midnight is that I would like very much to try to capture some of those nighttime special slimes because I want to make the cave open to us. I wanna just unlock this extra section over here and see if maybe we can store some of them. There's a little preview screenshot of what we're going to get to look like. Let's see how much it costs, 350. Okay, that's gonna be doable. So what we need is just to simply get a new source of food. It looks like the auto feeder has just been allowing our pink slimes to have a little bit of fun. And wow, they are jumping all the way up to the tip top. We're gonna need nets on basically all of these enclosures. But now let us venture out into the night and see what dangers lie in wait. There's my little glowy slimes. Let's see if we can get to them before they absorb any of the pink plorts. You're not allowed to eat those. There are a lot of pink plorts out here. Starting off with 3 phosphor slimes, we got 3 out of 4, that's pretty good, and getting at least 20 pink plorts is probably going to be helpful to us as well, because we do need that extra money not only to unlock the new zone, but also probably to buy some kind of pin for them once we get into the new zone. In the next area, we should be able to find ourselves some rock slimes to go with these. Luckily, we're catching these as soon as they bounce out of the ground, which is especially good for us. Let's see if we can get just as lucky with the rocks. Grabbing the phosphors along the way, starting with a healthy 7. Come here, my children! All right, we did capture the rock slime, but we're gonna have to take some damage to get any more. There's already 3 of them! And one of them has combined with... Oh, no. Oh, jeez. Okay, so I think we just witnessed the birth of one of these mud slimes. It looks like they consumed a 3rd plort. I think that is what happens when they eat too many. They start getting angry, and they start eating everything else. So when we come out at night and the phosphor slimes are out here too, making their own type of plort, that is what contributes to the problem. Our nighttime excursion's going pretty well so far. We've got 15 phosphor slimes, and I want to try a little bit of science. Okay, that didn't work. Not even close. I was seeing if the rock slime might be able to help kill the mud oil slimes, but alas, they were just immediately eaten instead. So, that didn't work. How do I get you to move? I wonder if I have to feed you something. So you don't even come up on the label at the top right of the screen. These guys normally eat meat, right? At least the smaller versions of them do, so... Why are you angry? What type of slime are you? I don't know, but it looks like you're gonna hurt me if you get too close. Or just jump into the ocean to your certain death! Alright, let's just get out of here. I got what I came for. I got the phosphor slimes. I only got one rock slime, so we're gonna have to try again during the day, see if we can get a little bit more lucky. Well, I managed to find a couple stragglers on the way back. Get in my belly! So now we have 3 rock slimes. That's a bit more acceptable, and very nearly 20 phosphor. These guys are still just springing out of the woodwork. I'm just gonna stand right here. Seems like they're respawning all around me immediately for some reason. Did I find a bug in the system? So let's say hello to all of our new rocky friends. We're probably going to need to upgrade their cage in the near future because they're going to start stacking even higher. Let's also check on our food sources, still growing, of course. We're probably going to fast forward sleep till morning, but we need the extra cash first. The price is 7 per pink plort right now. That's going to at least allow us to purchase 1 new pin upgrade. What can you upgrade in the storage unit? Additional storage! A silo can have up to 4 ports for storing plorts and resources. Okay, so it's not as useless as I initially assumed. You can just add extra little containers all along the sides. I'm guessing 1 on all 4. Silo better than I thought. That's good. Let's just dive straight in and see about unlocking the cave, the grotto. Have a little ding-a-ling music to let us know of our success, and the atmosphere immediately changes. Ooh, spooky. And there's a water source in here? Or is it just the sound of dripping? I think it might just be the sound of dripping. We've got 1, 2, 3 plots, plus the ramp. So there's actually 5 on this side. That is cool. Then the question becomes what to do with our phosphor slimes now. Will they disintegrate as the light rays come down from the crack in the cave? No, it appears that they're fine. Now, is it in fact daytime? Let us go take a look real quick. Yeah, it is. All right, so we can just let them roam free if we want to. They eat fruits. You know, we've got 20 phosphor slimes. Is it worth trying to pin them up? I think not. So let's just let them all roam free out here. It's gonna be a phosphor slime paradise. Now they just need to eat. So we're going to have to build some farms. Let's start down here on the lower level where I'm 100% sure they can all reach very easily a garden. We're gonna purchase this and we just need 1 berry to plant. And then they can start self-sustaining. Now the problem is going to arise in gathering their plorts. I'm not 100% certain how long they last until they disappear. Hopefully they're permanent. But then again, the fact that there's plenty of plorts out there that we never got, and if I was to return, would they despawn just by going too far away? I don't know. All of our carrots have sprouted and they're just lying here on the surface waiting for us to collect them. Make sure we plant 1 more before we leave and do the same thing for the fruits. There's so many chickens gobbling in here too. We can finally feed the tabbies. Now that they're laying eggs at 2x speed, this is all gonna be a much quicker process. Apparently, our efforts to make stony hens has been unsuccessful. Do we need a stony roostro as well? That might be a possibility. Or else I'm just getting very unlucky. I'm not 100% sure which. Food for everyone! Have some hen hens and don't destroy the net this time. Please, please do not. Carrots for my lovely rock slimes. I'm propelling them to try to help them escape. You guys can have all but one of these. I don't know if we'll need the one, but just in case. And we're still waiting on the last 7 from the auto feeder to disperse. In the meantime, we've got a whole 6. Do they only feed them 6 at a time? I'm confused. Auto feeder, I want to be able to program you to say how many that you need to send out per feeding cycle. Maybe we're overcrowding just a bit here in the corrals. I've got all the plorts from the feeding, and it's time to see how much money we're going to acquire. Something that occurs to me is that the oil slimes don't appear to have any kind of plort. Or maybe we just haven't discovered it yet. Obviously, it's probably worth... Well, is it worth making one? I don't know. What happens? We don't know how to destroy them. Maybe we just shoot them off of the edge if we can figure out how to vacuum them up. Something that would be really amazing as a full ranch upgrade is some kind of robot that just goes around collecting plorts from the free-range slums and delivering them back to the middle so that you don't have to run in here to grab them all the time. I missed. But yeah, having just a system like a vacuum tube that goes back to your house so that I don't have to come in here and try to clean up after all these when they inevitably eat surrounding the tree. Speaking of eating, we might either A, want to make another garden, or B, want to make some nutrient soil or a sprinkler. Do we want the maximum yield or do we want them to grow twice as fast? Well, if they grow twice as fast, we have to come back and replant, don't we? So we're gonna have to come back in here anyway. So it almost makes more sense to me just to get a tree going on the opposite side, perhaps. Let's get a secondary garden. I'm glad I brought 2 pogo fruits. And now they have a source of food. Hold on just a second. Where do you think you're going? They can fly. I thought they could only bounce. So apparently we wouldn't be able to corral them anyway unless we happened to have some type of lid, a ceiling. So hopefully they can't escape this cave. I don't think they're gonna be able to navigate through here. Maybe they can't go through the fire? I'm not sure, why is that fire even there? And what else do we want to do today? We've captured a new type of slime. We're gonna start getting some new plorts. Probably some more science or some more exploration. We did science last time. Let's go explore a new area that we haven't been to yet. Hold on, what? What is this? Have I walked past this every single day? Did that just give me one carrot? Get out of here. I don't even want the carrot. I am insulted by your gifts and offering, video game. I demand more tribute. All right, where are we going for real? I think if we just jump off this cliff to the left, I wonder if this will hurt us. How do we get out of here once we jump down? I guess we'll find out. Hey, it didn't kill me. No fall damage. Excellent. I suppose if we fall in the water, something awful will happen, though. So let's cross the bridge. I see there is a jumbo-sized pink slime. Now, what do you want? There is a fruit tree right nearby. Let's do some science. Let's do some experimenting, shall we? Mouth open. Eating. Yes. You've consumed 5 of these. I can't vacuum anything else away from you. Do we need to return with more food? Okay. We've got a new challenge, a new puzzle, perhaps. So join me as we attempt to solve the great pink puzzle next time. I hope you guys all had a great holiday, that you enjoyed this video, and that you have a wonderful new year. My name is Etalyx, and I'll see you back at the ranch.